Hey guys, it's Rich with your Monday spot in the Pagan Perspective. This week, our topic comes from Rob on via Facebook, and he asked the question about weather magic. He writes, "What do you guys know of weather magic and its practices? Have you had any experiences with it?" Now, I never thought of using weather in magic, or using, you know, or doing any magic for weather. Anything associated with weather magic, I haven't even given a thought to until about 2 months ago, I think-ish. I saw a tweet by Christopher Penzek on Twitter. I don't do Twitter that often, so I don't know much about it. But I did get on there, and I saw Christopher Penzek said something about, you know, weather magic. I don't know if he's writing a new book, just doing research, whatever. But I didn't even think of it until then. But weather can influence your magic greatly if you're really in tune to it. Say if you have a lightning storm or something like that, it can increase the energy around you or something to that effect. It can either, you know, give you more energy or take energy away, depending on how in tune you are with certain types of weather. Other than that, using magic to affect the weather, I know a friend that was able to kind of do that, but not something I really ever had a need to do. I usually just let the weather happen as it happens, and I go with the flow. So it's not really for me. As for actually using the weather to my advantage when doing spellcraft or any types of magic, I would say that it could be a possibility in the future, but right now I have no real need to use it. I gather my energy like I usually do, and it suits me for what I need to accomplish. So for me right now, in this stage of life, I'm not going to really need it, but it is something that I would put away back in my repertoire for later. So that's basically all that I have for this week. I know, a little short and sweet vlog here. So, that, like I said, that's all that I pretty much have on the subject. I don't know if Christopher Penzek is coming out with a book or a lecture series, something like that, but if you go back on Twitter, it, like I said, it's probably about 2 months back I saw it. And you might be able to find the tweet somewhere out there in cyberspace. So I, however, do not know how to do it, and I don't even know where to begin looking for it. But that's all that I have for now. Next week is subs week, and then I'll see you the week after. So until next time, may you have a great day, a better tomorrow, and happy Samhain to everybody. Bye-bye.